You guys, welcome back to another episode. Today's gonna be a little shorter because it's really more like an announcement video. I'm so excited to be officially revealing this on the channel. Bow hunting is finally coming to Until Journey's End. So what are we gonna be hunting? We're gonna be hunting white-tailed deer in my home state of Michigan. Why I'm so excited is because this is going back to my roots. I grew up in Michigan. I grew up hunting, grew up fishing. Hunting and fishing out there is so different than here in Southern California. So being able to share this with you is gonna be so, it's just gonna be so exciting for me. And we leave in a week. My wife and I are packing our stuff. We're gonna be there for about 2.5 weeks. And my goal is to come back with at least 2 episodes for you guys, possibly 3. Hunting for me taught me so many amazing things growing up as a kid. I remember one of my first successful hunts was a squirrel. I got a little squirrel with my BB gun. I think I was like 10 or 11 years old. My dad helped me skin it and we threw it in the crock pot and we ate it. And it was delicious, minus the fact that I didn't skin it very well and I was constantly pulling hair out of my mouth. Yeah, it was gross. That part was gross. And then when I turned 12, I was officially old enough to go hunting. I went out with my dad for my first ever hunt, and I shot my first deer. It was a great little 5-point buck, and it was a day I'll never forget. Hunting not only makes amazing memories with the people that you go out with, but it teaches you so many. It's taught me so many valuable lessons. The fact that an animal gave its life for you to have a meal for weeks and months on end. You know, these white-tailed deer that we're gonna be hunting, they feed my wife and I for months. One deer feeds us for about 3 months. Crazy fact, we actually don't really buy beef anymore because we have enough venison that will last us pretty much the whole year. So when I turned 16, I started to get into bow hunting. My dad bought me my first compound bow. And you guys are gonna notice something here. My dad is gonna be a big part of my whole hunting experience because him and I pretty much started hunting together. He started hunting white-tailed deer a couple years before I did, but he never really got into it until I was old enough to get into it. So we kind of went on that journey together. So after my dad bought me that bow, I started practicing. I mean, all the time. I just fell in love with shooting a compound. When deer season came and I went out on my first hunt, I shot my first doe, and that whole entire experience was, I want to say primal. You know, you feel connected with, you know, some part of your ancestry. But, you know, I'm using a compound. It's such a high tech evolution of the bow, but to be able to successfully pull off a shot on an animal takes a lot of work up front, which is what we're doing here at the range today. So that experience as a 16-year-old kid just changed my life, and I've been bow hunting ever since. Guys, the first episode of this deer hunt, Lord willing, as long as everything goes well, will drop sometime in November. Guys, I'm so excited to share this with you. Let's go shoot some arrows. So the reason why we're practicing sitting and standing is because I could be in either scenario when we're actually out in the woods hunting. The tree stand that we're gonna be hunting from, I'm gonna be sitting most of the time, and in fact, most of my shots will probably be from a seated position. But there are a few instances where I would have to stand in order to pull off a shot. So practicing from both stances and in multiple different positions is crucial, because every little minor adjustment goes into the ultimate accuracy of your arrow.